The world isn't black and white, and DND isn't just 9 shades of gray either. Today, let's talk about the often misunderstood BuzzFeed personality quiz of DND 5e. The concept of alignment in DND isn't all that hard to grasp. 2 parameters with only 3 choices that result in just 9 possible outcomes for your character. So then why do so many groups struggle with it? Before we answer that question, let's review those 9 possibilities for a character's alignment. Shown here are the 2 spectrums that dictate those possibilities. The first weighs the morality of a character or creature from evil to neutral to good. The other contemplates the beliefs of that entity as it pertains to adherence to the rules of society, from lawful to neutral to chaotic. To illustrate a few extreme examples of these alignments, a lawful evil individual might manipulate the tax structure of a kingdom to make themselves richer, or they might defile a religious monument adhering to the code of their lord or patron. On the other hand, a chaotic good individual might set fire to a piece of furniture to keep the tavern warm instead of using the fireplace, or they might empty the party's shared gold into the hands of a beggar on the street. Perhaps just these few examples might have already presented you with the first clue to understanding alignment properly. Law and morality are different depending on the lens of the individual in question and the society that they reside within. One might think that a group of cultists bent on summoning a devil to the material plane would certainly be wholly made up of chaotic evil parishioners. But maybe some of them tend closer to lawful as they obey the hierarchy of their dodgy religion. Maybe some of them honestly believe that calling forth this devilish entity is for the good of the realm.
But should not the actions of oneself dictate their alignment?
I would say, not necessarily. This only shifts the metric by which we measure from the individual to those around them. So then, who should be the judge? Well, it typically doesn't matter. What's most important here is that a character or creature's alignment makes sense to the players and the DM at the game table. It should be used as a guide for decision making and quickly understanding how your character might feel about a given situation that they aren't emotionally attached to. Which brings me to my next point. It's entirely possible for characters to act outside of their own alignments, given the right conditions. This isn't me telling you to metagame your own principles whenever it suits you. Such actions should still be compelled by the character's attachments, emotions, and backstory. As a general rule of thumb, I find that anytime I'm dealing with something that directly relates to my character's backstory, there may be a reason for me to act outside of my typical alignment. For example, a lawful good paladin might have taken an oath to never kill, but after directly witnessing the murder of someone dear to them, they may strike out blindly against their enemies in return and murder them in a rage. That action doesn't mean that the paladin is evil now. It means that they had a moment of weakness and will now need to deal with that emotional turmoil in the wake of losing someone close to them. That is textbook character development and some great storytelling tension. On the opposite end of the spectrum, a chaotic evil character might decide against robbing some poor commoner blind because they remember what it was like when they were poor. Does that mean that the character isn't chaotic evil anymore? Not really. They'll probably just go find a noble somewhere in town and swipe gold from them instead, maybe even killing them in the process. It's for this reason that I often tell others not to base their whole character off of one alignment. I usually don't give my own character their alignment until I have a firm grasp on their backstory, flaws, and ideals. You know, those blocks on the character sheet that most of us ignore. Truthfully, flaws and ideals can be much more telling when making decisions for your character in-game than just shoving their personality into one of only 9 boxes. Like I said, alignment is meant to be a guide for us in most situations, not an end-all be-all for what our character does in every situation. Use yourself as an example. How would you classify your own alignment? Does that alignment dictate everything you do? If you don't obey the speed limit sometimes, does that mean you're chaotic? I hope not. By the way, DMs shouldn't be afraid to deviate from the alignments found in the stat block for a creature either. Anomalies like these often make for some of the best social interactions as well as combat. Now, we should also talk about the elephant in the room here. Can alignment change? How much is too much before the DM should call for a shift in alignment? Well, that can be hard to quantify, but I'd wager that consistently acting outside of an alignment in situations that don't provoke some special emotional reaction over the course of a few sessions, well, that would warrant such a change. But that doesn't mean that you can do a bunch of bad stuff and then one good deed to keep your halo. I'd say of anything that I mentioned here, this is the trickiest bit to get right. The DM should be going by feel to determine when an alignment shift might be on the horizon, and a talk should be had before any final decisions. After all, maybe the player isn't entirely aware that they're acting out of character. Maybe a talk with the DM or even some in-game roleplay will shed some light on their blunder. And maybe, just maybe, it is intentional. In which case, it'd be a good idea for the DM to know that anyway. As usual, communication is going to be your friend here. And if you'd like to communicate with me that you found all this useful, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. So, until next time, go out there and make some chaos. You chaotic, evil son of a-